That particular day, she and two girlfriends were in a canoe near the far shore of the river that flowed quietly behind Boonesboro.
Daniel! Daniel! Jemima's gone!
Now, wait a minute. Now, hold up there. Settle down and tell me what happened.
I went down to the river with some washing, and a canoe floated right by. It was empty, Daniel.
Indians! And they got my Betsy!
And my Abby!
Hey, right. Simon, get a search party together. At least 10 men. Now tell them we're leaving now. Move!
It was a clear, lazy day in mid-July, 1776. The kind of day made for daydreaming and small talk. So perhaps Jemima Boone and her friends were a little less careful than usual as they floated by the far bank of the river. It was no problem at all for the Indians hidden in the tall marsh grass to tip their canoe and take them quietly before anyone else noticed they were gone.
Before you do anything, you better know that my father is Daniel Boone.
You, Boone's girl?
She nodded, yes.
And the others?
Those two, she lied. Well, this put matters in an entirely different light. Daniel Boone was well respected by the Shawnee. So it was decided to take the girls west to their camp. Chief Cornstalk would decide their fate.